There are 6 types of barking. Today, I'm going to show you dominant or aggressive barking, fearful barking, and territorial barking. The main thing you need to know about barking is that barking is not a problem. It's a symptom of a problem. Find out what the problem is, and you'll be able to address the barking. If your dog is showing a dominant or aggressive bark, don't try to fix the problem yourself. Seek help from a certified trainer. Mistakes you make in correcting the aggressive behavior might only make the problem worse and can be dangerous to try to fix by yourself. This type of bark can be seen often by dogs on leash as they lunge at other dogs or people. It can also be seen between 2 dogs playing if one gets out of hand and it escalates, or often between same-sex dogs. Fearful barking is simply seen as remove the object or person that frightens the dog and he will stop barking. Fear can be seen when a dog tries to run backwards away from you as he's barking, or even an unsure look. I don't know this dog, but watch as his body clearly shows his fear of the vacuum. He doesn't bark, but in this situation, many dogs would bark out of fear. Petting the dog and hugging him will only make the situation worse. In some cases of fear, the person or object cannot be removed, like going to the vet or having visitors in your home. In cases such as these, it's best to contact a certified trainer to help you and your dog overcome these fears. Trying to correct the problem yourself may lead to fear aggression if not properly addressed. Territorial barking is one of the main types of barking. Most of us do it and love doing it. It's just so gratifying. Territorial barking is us telling you to stay away from our property. It's an area, not an object. A dog barking to keep you away from his object, like a bone or toy, would be barking aggressively. Our territory can be a car, a house, a yard, or even a city block. But first things first. When I see a person walking by my house and I bark at him, he continues to walk and doesn't stop. I'm so proud of myself because I got him to keep going and not stop at my house. Mom says I'm a little far-fetched with this, but I'm telling you, it works. I bark and they don't stop, so obviously my barking worked. The house and my family are saved. How do you correct this problem if everywhere you look, we have something to bark at? If you allow us access to look out a window, then it's for sure we'll find something to bark at. Here's my friend Kodak showing you what territorial barking looks like in the house. Restrict our access to look out the window and we won't have any reason to bark. Mom says this is easier said than done, but there are tools you can find in an animal supply store to help you. Here's my friend Kira showing you what territorial barking looks like when greeting someone at the door. First, don't allow your dog to jump on the couch and look out the living room window. If preventing your dog from looking out the window is impossible, then you can buy an X mat, which is a plastic mat with spikes. I wouldn't want to step on that, and neither will your dog. Ouch! One of my mom's favorite tools is a spray collar. She's never used it on me, but I've heard that my brother Granite used to bark excessively and he got to wear it. Mom says that this collar rarely works on its own, especially with breeds that love water like Labradors. But there's a trick to bring up your chances of making it work. Buy an empty spray bottle at the dollar store and fill it with water. When your dog barks near you, then be fast and spray your dog in the eyes with the water while saying no. You must get the water directly in the eyes for it to work. Imagine it's a hot day and a friend uses a water gun to spray you. Feels great, doesn't it? Now imagine that same friend sprays you in the eyes. It doesn't hurt, but it doesn't feel good either. That's how we feel. The sound of the spray will eventually be associated with the spray from the collar, which will help the collar to work even when you're not around by creating a negative association to the sound of the spray. Mom says to use the spray bottle at least 1 week before beginning the use of the collar as instructed on the package instructions. This can take months to fully work and will work indoors and outdoors if done properly. Training us is not an overnight job. If for any reason this doesn't work, or your dog is becoming nervous or fearful, then please contact a certified trainer in your area. Did you know that a few small dog breeds were bred to bark? They were used as alarms to bark excessively to wake the house if there was something wrong or an intruder. For this reason, some small dog breeds can be more difficult to curb the habit of barking. Stay tuned for the next episode as I tell you all about excited barking, learn barking, and boredom barking.